Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I'm going to make a big claim because I'm going to show you a guaranteed way that you can remove flicker from your videos in Premiere Pro, Final Cut, DaVinci Resolve, basically any video editing software. This tutorial is going to show you two methods for flicker removal, with the first method being a quick and easy trick for removing flicker that may help you, and the second method being a more advanced way to remove really stubborn flicker that the first method can't help. If method number one doesn't work, I guarantee you that method number two will. Let's get the first flicker removal method out of the way really fast. And this is something that you may have seen other people talk about because the vast majority of flicker removal tutorials on YouTube cover this technique. I'm going to show you how to do it in Premiere, but you can use the same technique in any other video editing software and it will work the same. The quick and easy way to remove flicker is to simply take your video clip that has flicker, hit play on this clip here, and you'll see a lot of flicker, especially on the outfits of these people as they're dancing. To fix it, simply take your video clip that has flicker, hold down the Alt key and drag up to duplicate that clip, press plus to zoom in, move over one frame, zoom back out, and then set the opacity of your upper clip to 50%. Hit play, check it out, flicker is removed. And the only side effect here is that there's a slight amount of increased motion blur in your footage. Pretty easy, right? But what if this doesn't remove the flicker? What if you try and you notice that the lights are stubbornly still flickering? Check out this example here. We've got a couple dancing and a lot of flicker. We've got two lights back here in the background flickering at different rates. There's flickering on the bride's dress. It's a lot of flicker and it's everywhere. I'm gonna try to fix it like we just did with the previous clip by copying the clip, dragging it over the other clip, and then setting the opacity to 50%. But when I hit play, that really didn't fix anything. It still looks bad and now it's just a lot of flicker with motion blur. This is where flicker removal method number two comes in. And this is my method for removing really stubborn flicker that doesn't want to disappear. And here's the good news. With this method, I have never had it fail. I have always been able to remove the flicker using this technique. Does that sound cool? Kind of magical? Okay, here's how it works. First, let me get the bad news out of the way. You are going to need to buy a plugin called Flicker Free from a company called Digital Anarchy. And at the time of making this video, this plugin costs $149. Yes. I'm sorry. Unfortunately, this technique is not free, but this is a plugin that I use multiple times per year, and I'm betting you will as well, and I think that it's completely worth it. Plus, it works with Premiere Pro, Final Cut, DaVinci Resolve, etc., so it should work with your video editing software. I will link to this plugin down below. As another plus, they do offer a demo of the plugin on Windows, so if you're not sure whether you're going to be able to remove your flicker from your videos, and you're using Premiere or Resolve, you can download the demo, put it on your clip, test it out, and make sure the flicker is removed before you put your money down on it. Sorry, Final Cut users, they don't have a demo for you. Also, for the sake of ethics here really quick, I want you to know this video isn't paid or sponsored by Digital Anarchy or anyone else for that matter. I've bought this plugin with my own money and I'm talking to you about it because I love it. Okay. Bad news about the cost of the plugin out of the way. Let's get to the awesome stuff. Download the Flicker Free plugin and install it, and then whenever you have a video clip with very bad, stubborn flicker that does not want to be removed, like this clip here, open up your effects control panel where you can find the Flicker plugin, drag Flicker Free over to your video clip, hit play, and wait a second, the flicker is still here. What the heck? Well, out of the box, Flicker Free can be a little finicky, so let's dial in some settings. There are two critical settings for Flicker Free that make the most difference. The first thing that you're going to need to pay attention to here are these presets. And by default, the preset is set to rolling bands, which usually works pretty well. If that doesn't work, I would recommend going through and selecting some of these other presets and seeing if that makes things look better. One of my favorite presets is the slow motion preset, which, as its name implies, should work well with slow motion footage. Let's select slow motion and hit play again. And it looks like the slow motion preset has fixed some of the flicker in this clip. But notice now that there's this weird ghosting effect on the motion in the clip. It looks like the couple's arms have a motion trail. To fix that, check this motion compensation box and check it out. Ghosting is gone and the couple's motion looks a whole lot better. But look over here, and we still have this pesky flicker that isn't being fixed by the plugin because this light is flickering at a different rate than the other lights. So here's a trick. You don't have to apply flicker-free just once. You can apply it multiple times. That said though, I would not recommend just dragging the flicker-free effect onto your clip again or nesting the clip. This can confuse the plugin, and I found that it usually crashes or makes Premiere super slow. Instead, I would apply one pass of flicker-free just like we did, then take your video clip and render it out as its own standalone video file. Then re-import this new video file back into your video editing software, and you'll see here that I've re-imported it with this demo.mp4 clip. Hit play on this, and see we've baked in some of this flicker removal, and now we only have this light over here on the left to deal with. Now let's deal with the rest of this flicker. First, we're gonna go back over to effects, grab the flicker free plugin and drag it back over to this new clip. Then let's set the preset to slow motion again, and I'm also going to go here and change the threshold from 20% to 100%. You can think of the threshold setting as how sensitive the plugin is to light flickering. If it's a big flicker going from very bright to very dark like this light is, then setting the threshold higher will make the plugin detect it. Let's test this now, and look at that. Dang, the flicker is gone. You would not even know there'd been flicker in this clip. Isn't that cool? That's really cool. But hold on a second. The couple is now looking super ghosty with a lot of motion trails. No problem. Let's go back over here, turn on motion compensation, hit play, and dang it, we fixed the motion blur, but now the flicker is back. Time to fix this once and for all. The last thing that you need to know about flicker-free is that you can choose which parts of your clip that you want to apply the effect to. In this case, I just want to apply it to this flickering light on the left and completely ignore the couple. So let's uncheck motion compensation, and then I want you to click on the mask pin tool and change the fit to 25% so we have much better view around the clip. I'm gonna click five times, once here, once here, once here, once here, and once here. Then I'm gonna change the mask feather, kind of soften out this mask here a little bit, and check this out. Hit play, and the flicker is gone, and the couple are not ghosting. Do you remember how bad this clip looked initially? This is incredible. I love it. It's completely fixed. Do you see how powerful this plugin is? All right, so if you have any flicker in your videos, I would first try removing it by using the simple trick of duplicating your clip on top of itself, moving it over one frame, and setting the opacity to 50%. But if you have a very stubborn flicker that isn't being removed, or if you aren't happy with the added motion blur that you're getting using this technique, investing in the flicker-free plugin can save your video clips. In fact, check out the original clip that I fixed at the start of the video. Here's the clip being fixed by duplicating, and here's the same clip, but I used flicker-free with the motion compensation box checked. There's much less motion blur. With that, thank you so much for watching this flicker removal tutorial. I've linked down below to the flicker-free plugin, as well as a link to my color presets that I used to color the clips in this video. It would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more videos about filmmaking and video editing in the future. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.